Okay, look. Don't get too used to this. I just thought that I'd compile a list of really cool methods for training that I either figured out on my own or found out by looking stuff up. Some of these videos have something like 10 minutes for a singular trick, and that's why I'm making this. The last thing that I want to do is waste your time, so let's just get into it. So the most important thing for this video is what the intention is. This is a late post-game video. I'm not here to tell you how to get statisticians. There are countless guides on that already, and this video will be assuming that you've already unlocked the Carnage dimension at the very least. This will also have less editing and humor than my other videos. It's just tips, you know? So right off the bat, I just want to drill into you right away that aptitudes aren't as important as you might think. That's some real in-level stuff, and you only really want it if you've maxed out everything else, and I don't really advise it on more than a few characters. Don't really worry about getting it on everyone. Aptitudes are an additive bonus, not multiplicative when tacked onto your weapon and armor mastery. So in reality, you're not getting like an extra 200% extra stats, you're just getting the other half of your item stats, granted that your aptitudes are the baseline hunters across the board, which I assure you that they won't be. Keep it in the back of your head, but don't sweat it, you're gonna hit stat cap anyway, and you don't really need that for most of the content in the game. It's just something nice to have on a few characters. So for the first real tip, let's talk about innocence. Stat innocence are important early on, but not at all later. The most important thing for you to grab is professionals. Now some dumbass mistranslated its description, it actually increases critical damage percent. Also, don't worry about cloning shit. Just put it on your trap later and it'll come naturally. Everything else is really just flair. Don't worry too much about it. Second tip, eat curry. I really slept on this one, partially because I didn't understand the aging mechanics, even though the game clearly hints at it. The short and sweet of this is that every stage you clear ages your curry by a day. This means that your curry will last an extra stage when you finally do eat it. It stacks up to 100. By going to the other section and putting in 100 thimbles, you can get a 100% crit rate. You can make another curry while you're currently using one, so it's like a guaranteed damage boost on everyone in your group, especially when combined with the previous tip. Also, you can boost your HP massively by using Carnage Elixirs as the base. It definitely helps for item world and shard farming, so don't sleep on it. So for the third tip, you're gonna wanna learn Raspberryl's abilities. You can pass them around through character world. She learns Recruitment Drive and Innocent classes. Recruitment Drive will power up your surrender rate, and it stacks with Megaphone, which will cut down on how many trips that you need to do before you hit the captive rate of 128. The ability Innocent Classes boosts your Innocent growth rate by 3% just for someone sitting inside of the squad. I don't know how powerful a 3% to Innocent growth is, but it's probably additive to the base rate, so there's really no reason not to get it. This next tip is really strong. Valvatores and Fuka have the abilities Prinny Instructor and Prinny Hat respectively. Prinny Instructor is an EXP, mana, and class EXP boost to any Prinnies in your squad. Prinny Hat will turn anyone with it on into a Prinny. Putting it on everyone in a 20-unit squad, that's a free 2000% boost on everyone. You're going to want these on 20 units, preferably on units that you plan on actually using. Go into the character world, and you can do this on easy difficulty to speed the process up. After that's done, let's talk about proficiency. We can magic change 4 monsters onto a strong unit that we have, then we can stack a bunch more units on top. In a tower, all units will split EXP evenly, but EXP caps out just below the requirement for some classes to max out. This means that realistically, you're going to be getting less class EXP than a solo unit, but in the right circumstances, with high stats and proper setup, you will be able to power level 13 classes through class mastery, all at the same time. It will take longer than a normal setup to do since it requires you to pull a metric ton of units out, but it will allow you to easily get mastery for unique units, which cannot switch into monster classes. Make sure that everyone you're training is in whatever squad that you're using to power level. Anyone in the tower is splitting base EXP and they're affected by their own multipliers. The exception is magic change units who will share 100% of their host's gains. I'm not too sure how much faster it is than normal methods, but my least favorite part of this is exiting out of stage select to swap out classes. If you feel the same way, leveling up in bulk like this saves time. If you're having issues killing strong enemies, you can grab the bodyguard ability from Thimo Laharl and slap it onto all the units in your squad, granting everyone across the board 100% attack modifier just for existing. Gender Bender is cheap, and so is this ability. This trick will allow you to speedrun through just about everything that you come up against. And that's all. Hopefully you learned something new or remembered something that you forgot. I'm not claiming that any of this is groundbreaking, but with how I had to find most of this out from different sources, I felt that I should compile some of it. Anyways, have a good day, and I'll see you guys later.